Hello, I'm Vidas Pinkevičius, and in this video I would like to tell you a story about how one famous German organist and composer, Helmut Walcha, learned organ pieces from memory, how he learned them to memorize, basically. You know, he was vaccinated against smallpox at the age of 19, and because of this vaccination he became blind. So he was one of these famous blind organists, and you see, because he was blind, he had to find a way to read music without actually relying on the score. So what he did, actually, he obviously had to play from memory, but the way he learned music is, he asked his students later in his life, he asked his students to play an excerpt of an organ piece, maybe 2 measures long excerpt of one voice only, one single part, one, let's say, soprano part for him, and the student would play him the soprano part once or twice, and then Helmut Walcha would repeat it, and basically memorize these 2 measures, right? So then he asked the student to play another part, maybe alto part, of the same 2 measures fragment, and the same was done. He repeated from memory the alto part, right, like a few times, and then he asked to play the student for him the tenor part, right, and then he repeated from memory, and then the same was with bass. So he learned this fragment of 2 measures, part by part, voice by voice, basically, and then he combined them together. I'm not sure whether he combined two-part combinations like soprano, alto, soprano, tenor, soprano, bass, alto, tenor, alto, bass, tenor, bass, or 3-part combinations, or whether he played all 4 parts after learning a single part, right? I'm not sure about that, but at any rate, he learned separate parts first. And then the student would play for him another fragment of 2 measures, also one part at a time. And it's entirely possible that he would, after learning separate parts, he would really play 2-part combinations, right, and 3-part combinations, and only then 4-part combinations in a polyphonic piece like Bach, because Helmut Walcha was an expert in playing Bach. He was so renowned, his recordings on historical organs of organ masterpieces by Bach became world known, basically. And of course his performance of the Art of Fugue by Bach was also very, very famous and important and influential. In fact, he completed the last Richard card, which was unfinished in Bach's handwriting, completed and made it a final completed fugue, and recorded the entire cycle. So this story was told to me by George Ricci, who was a student of Helmut Walcha in Germany, and George Ricci was a teacher of mine at the University of Nebraska Lincoln when I did my doctorate there. So I remember him telling me a story and also encouraging me to try this way of learning a polyphonic piece, such as just like a fugue by Bach, part by part, basically, voice by voice, and then in combinations, everything from memory, right? Of course, I could see the music, so I looked at the score, and I would see the music and play from music, from the score, and then memorize. But at any rate, I also did it from memory. So this experiment really worked for me, And it might also work for you, not only because it's very thorough way to memorize music, but you will know this piece by heart very deeply, because if you know the piece only in four parts, that's not sufficient, right? But if you know each part separately, and you could play measure 28, the alto part, right, or the soprano part separately, then you really, really know this piece very well. And Helmut Walcha, of course, because of this method, learning in fragments and in separate voices, and I suspect in voice combinations also from memory, because of that, he learned any organ work by Bach, for example, this way, in small two-measure fragments, and then he combined those fragments together. And the benefit of this method is that it gives you a thorough knowledge of the piece, and it's the memory, the piece sinks into your long-term memory very much for a long time, and even years after he learned a fugue, for example, he would then, for example, ask his student one important question, whether in measure 28 in the alto part, is there a half note or quarter note, dotted quarter note, and the eighth note rest. You see, a small detail like that, he would know this piece even years after learning, right? But he had to only brush up a few important elements, like rests, like slurs, maybe like dots. But because of this voice by voice learning from memory, he would really remember these pieces for a long time. So you want also to try something like that on your own. With one piece, you do not need to play everything like Walcha did, but just take your favorite polyphonic piece, and it doesn't have to be very long, right? Maybe a few pages, and try to do this experiment, learning with the method of Helmut Walcha, and then take another piece and memorize the way you are used to, right? And then you can compare the result. Which one is better for you, which one works better, which one is faster, which one is deeper, which one is more enjoyable. So good luck in your practice, and I'll see you again next time. Bye bye. Thank you for watching.